بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. So today we are discussing strategic control. Okay, that is one of the control mechanisms. So we are discussing control function of management. Okay. Now strategic control is another type of control. It is aimed at ensuring that organization is maintaining an effective alignment with its environment and moving towards achieving its strategic goals. Okay. So this is a very important aspect of control mechanisms. As we discussed in the planning process, that organization exists for a purpose, and there is a goal and a mission and vision and a mission of the organization. And that mission and vision that is actually in line with the overall external environment. So that is why it is very much important that the organization that is purposeful and that is adding positively to the society. Now, organizations that can be measured overall by the strategic control mechanisms. Okay? So how you will determine that an organization that is effective? Okay, so there is an organizational effectiveness criteria. And that means that how an organization that is effective. Effective means that how it is successful in achieving the mission and vision for which the organization is existing. So there are three criteria on the basis of which we can measure whether an organization that is effective or not. So currently, the first criteria that currently the organization should be effective. Effective means in attainment of the goal for which the organization is set. So organization must be achieving their goal. And the second criteria is the efficiency. That is, it should be efficient in acquisition and use of resources. Okay, so and the third is that it should be a source of satisfaction for the owner, employee, customers and clients, and society. So this is the criteria under which we can measure whether an organization is currently effective or not. So organization should not only serve the owner, but rather the employees, the customers, and the overall society as well. And it must be effective and efficient. That is, it should utilize its resources efficiently and effectively for the attainment of the goals. Now, the second criteria is in the near future. So in the intermediate future, the organization must be adaptive for the new opportunities and threats, capable of developing for itself as well as its related members. Okay. So as you know that there is a rapid change in the external environment, and there is new technologies that are emerging, new demands, new markets that emerge rapidly, new developments that come. And until and unless an organization is not adaptive, okay, so it is only the change. It is only the change that exists. Okay? Only the change is permanent. So organization must keep itself with the changing environment. Otherwise, organization and its services or its products that will become obsolete if it is not competing with the challenges that is posed by the environment. So it must be adaptive. And it must be capable of developing itself as well as its related members. So this is the second criteria. The third criteria, that in the distant future, the organization must be capable of survival. So that is a very important aspect of the organization, that the organization that must survive in the long run. And for that, it is important that organization must keep its pace with the changing environment. So it means that even if an organization is currently effective and efficient, but that is not capable of to become adaptive, then it will perish. And you have many examples. For example, The best example that can be given by these cellular phones. So if you see that about a decade ago, the Nokia, that was the most important brand. But at that time, the Samsung and the other companies, so they were far behind. But the Nokia that was not changing and was not keeping pace with the changing environment. So you can see that what is now the type of mobile phone that are prevalent in the society. So the change that is always mandatory. Then how the strategic control mechanisms that work. So strategic control mechanism that looks differently to the organization than the traditional control mechanisms. Okay? So strategic control should motivate people toward desired organizational behavior rather than promote dysfunctional behavior. It means that the organization must do capacity building of the organization, of the employees towards attaining the goals and objectives of the organization. So if you look at this flow sheet, so in the traditional control mechanisms, what is done is that, for example, you are measuring budgets, meeting budget, production efficiency, inputs, quantitative performance. That is mostly in terms of financial aspects. So that is a traditional approach towards control mechanisms or solving the problems of the organization. But look at the strategic control mechanism that is totally different approach towards the same goal. So and all these things in the strategic control mechanisms, there is customer satisfaction. That is the most important criteria. Customer satisfaction, because all that organization is existing is because of the customer, because of the demand and market. So if the customer is not satisfied, so whatever the product and whatever development you are doing, so that will all be in vain. So customer satisfaction is important. Similarly, new product development rates means that there must be new products. Okay? New product development that must be there because new demands are there, new markets, opportunities that arise. And if you are not getting to those, so you will lose an opportunity or you will be into a type of competitive threat. Similarly, outcomes. What are the outcomes of your organizational criteria? And similarly, quantitative and qualitative performance. So that is very much important. Okay? So this is a very important aspect or perspective to viewing an organizational effectiveness. So the traditional approach, that is a type of just a trivial type of control mechanism that will not work to sustain the organization in the long run. Similarly, who is evaluated? So in the traditional approach, the organization individuals, functions and responsibility centers that are measured. For example, the individuals, ACRs, similarly functions of the bodies of the different departmental units. Okay? And responsibility centers mean there are different types of head of the departments or the like. Okay? In the strategic control mechanisms, the individuals, of course, and then there are teams. Okay, that is the groups that are measured, and there is cross-functional people. Okay, that okay, so that is the difference between the two approaches. Okay, similarly, reward control system difference. So if you see that it is again different in traditional control mechanisms, the emphasis is on the efficiency, profits, and return on investment. So these are actually two perspectives of looking into the organization. So efficiency, profit, and return on investment, that how much you are earning on investment. And in the strategic control, you are emphasizing on the quality, innovation, how much innovation you are bringing, creativity, and overall company performance. So look at the difference and the approach towards the same problem. Similarly, the focus on the contemporary control mechanisms, so that is also differing. So in the traditional control, it is based on the internal mechanism, meaning that the organization only emphasizes on the internal mechanisms rather than seeing the external environment or where the organization is operating. And in the strategic control, you are looking to the macro environment. Macro environment means that what is the situation of the global market? What is your product or the value of your product in the external market? And what are your competitors doing? How are they developing? And similarly, what is the industry environment? What new products are coming? What new types of programs are launched, for example? And of course, the internal environment as well. Okay, so now the strategic evaluation and control. So the firm's internal and external environments are dynamic. What should be the strategy review? So the firm's internal and external environments are dynamic. Therefore, the best conceived and implemented strategies become obsolete. Means that how much the better you plan, that will ultimately become obsolete with the changing environment. So that is why there must be a review of the systems. Now, there are three basic aspects of the strategy evaluation. Number first is examining the underlying basis of the firm strategy. What is the underlying basis of the firm strategy? That is, from where the organization is deriving its purpose of existence. What is the vision and mission of the organization? So that is very much important. That is, for example, if you are a health organization, so whether the aspect of health your organization is targeting, so whether you are achieving that, or what are the dynamics of that particular aspect of the health, for example. Similarly, comparing the actual to expected results. What are the actual results and what results can be expected? And similarly, taking corrective action to address performance gaps. Taking corrective action to address performance gaps. Now, effective strategy evaluation, how you will be performing that. So adequate and timely feedback. Means that there should be an adequate and timely feedback. You must know the proper evaluation criteria as we discussed in the control mechanism. So that is actually the cornerstone of the effective evaluation. Okay, so then the strategy evaluation, it must have both short and long-term focus. As you discussed, the organizations that exist that will exist in the far future. So there must be a short and long-term focus on certain aspects of the organization. Now there are four criteria under which the strategy that is reviewed. Number first is consistency. The second one, that is the consonance. Consonance means that how you are compatible, your goals are compatible with each other and with the environment. Feasibility, of course, and similarly, your competitive advantage. Okay, so the first one, there is consistency. So a strategy should not present inconsistent goals and policies. Consistency means that, as I showed you in the class, that the strategic plan that must be SOPs and the policies in the frontline supervisor that must be in line with the administrative core and that must be in line with the strategic core. So all the policies that must be in line to achieve the same goals and objectives. So if managerial problems continue despite changes in the personnel and are issue based, then strategies may be inconsistent. For example, you are control mechanism that are including staff transfers, or for example, hiring of the new staff or the such, and still the issues persist. So it means that there is problem in the strategies. Similarly, if success for one department means failure for the other department, then strategies may be inconsistent. That is another criteria. And the thirdly, if policy or the problem issues continue to be brought to the top for resolution, that all the problems that are accumulating to the top level management for decision, then strategies may be inconsistent. The second aspect there is the consonance. So consonance means strategist needs to examine sets of trends as well as individual trends in evaluating strategies. Strategy must be must represent within it. Similarly, most trends are the result of internal and external factors in the organization goals and objectives and its internal environment that must be in line with the overall external environment. So organization must be seen in totality, not in its part. So gets its goals and objectives effectively and efficiently. The third aspect that is feasibility. So the strategy unsolvable sub problems. Whether the strategic changes you are doing is feasible or not. So can the strategy be attempted within the physical, human, and financial resources of the enterprise? So it must be evaluated. Similarly, limitation and strategic choice imposed. And similarly, important to examine is competency, skills, and talent to carry out assess whether the organization is in a position to execute the new strategy or not, or it will create further problems. And then strategy review so in और मल्टीपल
सर आपकी आवाज कट रही है
अभी भी कट रही है
सर अभी ठीक हो गई है लेकिन बीच में कट रही है बार बार
हेलो हेलो कैन यू हियर मी
जी सर अभी सही हो गई है
आवाज सही हो गई अभी
जी सर सही हो गई है
सो as the external environment that is highly complex and there are multiple factors and sub factors so difficulty in predicting the future with accuracy that is also a problem that there are new dilemmas new problems for example this COVID-19 that is a new type of order a new norm has been developed over the 2 years rather than the previous one. So sometimes an unforeseen event that change all the courses. And similarly, increasing number of variables. So because of a number of variables that are difficult, so that is why strategic planning that is very much important, but that is very much difficult as well. And that is requiring very high class brains and brainstormings and think tanks and the like. Best at that time, but it gets obsolete very quickly because of the changing environment that is no more working. Similarly, increase in the domestic and world events, there is also a factor. Similarly, decreasing time span for which planning can be done with any certainty means that you can plan only for a with certainty for a short-term planning. And in the long run, you must be taking risks. As we discussed that in the strategic planning, uncertainties are more as compared to the short-term plans. Mm-hmm. doing strategic planning. And that include the structure. Okay, what is the structure of the organization? Similarly, the leadership, very much important. The technology that the organization will be adopting, the human resources that are present, okay, and similarly the information and control system that are available with the organization. Maybe discuss in detail, but we are going just through it just briefly. Similarly, the extent to which the criteria is met in order to facilitate the accomplishment of goals will determine the control measures in the form of, for example, you are doing strategic review. So ultimately, you may come across any of these changes or any of these corrective measures. Status quo, that is one aspect that you should maintain the status quo. The second one is the changes. Okay, changes, for example, changes in the structure, whether there is changes needed in the structure, there is replacement of the key leadership that is required, or there is adoption of new technologies that is missing till now. Similarly, modification and all changes in the information operational control. The strategic review mechanism. Okay? So this is the actual the overall control or controlling. This current today's lecture that can best be applied to university financial issues. Currently, financial issues, and that is because of the traditional approach towards controlling and not taking not doing proper strategic planning for the long run, and these problems that must be fixed for the organization, the old organization like UOP to sustain. So thank you very much. If you have any question, you can ask. Thank you.